Welcome students, I am Surya Prakash, MCA department, Engineering College, Bikaner. In the previous two lectures, we discussed clustering techniques using K-means algorithm. Now here we will discuss another algorithm, that is K-Medoid algorithms and its variants called PAMs in heat. Here they are called as partition around Medoid algorithm. The motivation behind K-Medoid algorithm is that we have learned that the K-means algorithm is sensitive to outliers because an object with an extremely large value may substantially distort the distribution. The effect is particularly exacerbated due to the use of SSE, that is sum of square error objective function. The K-Medoid algorithm aims to diminish the effects of outliers. The basic concept is that the basic concept of this algorithm states that select an object as a cluster center, one of the representative object per cluster, instead of taking the mean value of the object in a cluster as in K-means algorithm. We call this cluster representative as a cluster medoid or simply medoid. Initially, it selects a random set of k objects as the set of medoids. Then, at each step, all objects from set of objects which are not currently medoid are examined one by one to see if they should be medoids. That is, a K-Medoid algorithm determines whether there is an object that should replace one of the current medoids. This is accomplished by looking all pair of medoids and non-medoid objects and then choosing a pair that improves the objective function of clustering the best and exchange them. For this we use sum of the absolute error, that is SAE function is used as a objective function. Here the SAE has a formula, that summation. Summation of from I is equal to k is and then mod of difference of the centroids. That CM denotes the medoid, M is the set of all medoids at any instant, and X is an object belongs to set of non-medoid object. That is, X belongs to some cluster and is not a medoid. Now, partitioning around medoid or the K-Medoid algorithm is a partitional clustering algorithm which is slightly modified from the K-means algorithm. And we will see this, that they both attempt to minimize the squared error, but the K-Medoid algorithm is one more robust to noise than K-Means algorithm. In K-Means algorithm, they choose means as the centroids, but in K-Medoids, data points are chosen to be the medoid. A K-Medoid can be defined as that object of a cluster whose average dissimilarity to all the objects in the cluster is minimal. The difference between K-means and K-medoid is analogous to the difference between mean and median, where mean indicates the average value of all the data items collected, while median indicates the value around that which all data items are evenly distributed around it. The basic idea of this algorithm is to first compute the k representative objects, which are called as medoids. After finding the set of medoids, each object of the data set is assigned to the nearest medoid, that is, object I is put into cluster VI when medoid MVI is nearer than any other medoid, that is MW is chosen. The algorithm proceeds in two steps. The first step states that this step sequentially selects k centrally located object to be used as initial medoids. Then second step says that if the objective function can be reduced by swapping a selected object with an unselected object, then the swap is carried out. This is continued till the objective function can no longer be decreased. In k-medoid, so initially we select, first step is that it selects k random points as the medoids from the given n data points of the data set. Then second step is that associate each data point to the closest medoid by using any of the most common distance metrics. Third, for each pair of non-selected object H and selected object I, calculate the total swapping cost TC IH. If TC IH is less than 0, I is replaced by H. And the last step says that repeat the steps 2-3 until there is no change of the medoids. Now the four situations to be considered here in k-medoid algorithms. The first one is shift out membership. An object PI may need to be shifted from currently considered cluster of OJ to another cluster. It simply means that if an object is eligible to move to another cluster, then move it from the current. Second step is update the current medoid, and on after shift the current medoid is recalculated and a new medoid OC is found to replace the current medoid OJ. Yes, current medoid is uploaded and the new medoid is selected from the current and replace the current medoid. The third step says that no change object in the current cluster result have the same or even smaller square error criterion SEC measure for all the possible redistributions considered. Now the fourth step says that shift in membership an outside object PI is assigned to the current cluster with the new replaced medoid OC. Repeat the steps 2-3 until there is no change of medoids. Now, K-medoid algorithm examples. PAM works efficiently for small data sets but does not scale well for large data set. The complexity of this algorithm is O K n minus K whole to the power 2. For example, for a given K is equal to 2, that is for K, we have considering that for two clusters and 10 data points have been data set. Along their x-axis and y-axis, the values are 0.1, 7, 6, 0.2, 2, 6, 0.3, 3, 8, 4, 8, 5, 5, 7, 4, 6, 4, 7, 7, 7 point says that x-axis is 6, y, 2, 8, 7, 4, 9th point is at 6, 4, and 10th point 3 and 4. For example, let us choose that 3, 4 and 7, 4 are medoids, initial medoids that we really choose. This is the only difference in the k-means and k-medoids algorithm. Suppose considering the Manhattan distance matrix as the distance measure. Now, if we calculate the distance from each point, that is in the both clusters, 4, 7, 6, for point number 7 to 6. Calculating the distance from medoids chosen, this point is nearest to 7, 4. Yes. For 2, 6. Calculating the distance from the medoids chosen, this point is nearest to 3, 4. For 3, 8. Calculating the distance from the medoids chosen, this point is at the same distance from both the points. So choosing that is nearest to 3, 4. Now the next point is 8, 5. For 8, 5, calculating the distance from the medoid chosen, this point is nearest to 7, 4. For 7, calculating the distance from the medoids chosen, this point is nearest to 3, 4. Now for the next point, 7, 3, calculating the distance from the medoids chosen, this point is nearest to 7, 4. For 6, 4, that is the last. Calculating the distance from the medoids chosen, this point is nearest to 7, 4. So, now after the clustering, the clusters formed are 3, 4, 2, 6, 3, 8, and 4, 7. In the first cluster, and the second cluster contains the points 7, 4, 6, 2, 6, 4, 7, 3, 8, 5, and 7, 6. That forms the second cluster. Now, calculating the cost, which is nothing but the sum of distance of each non-selected point from the selected point, which is medoid of the cluster it belongs to. Now total cost for the above example can be calculated using all particular points cost. That is cost of 7, 3, 4, 2, 6 plus cost of 3, 4, 3, 8, cost of 3, 4, 3, 4, 7, cost of 7, 6 and so on. Their cost would be 3 plus 4 plus 4 plus 3 plus 1 plus 1 plus 2 plus 2 is equal to 20. That's how the total cost is calculated. Then the total cost when 7.3 is the medoid greater than the total cost when 7.4 was medoid earlier. Hence 7.4 should be chosen instead of 7.3 as a medoid because it has a cost to glass, that is 20. Since there is no change in the medoid set, the algorithm ends here. Hence the clusters obtained finally are 3, 4, 2, 6, 3, 8, 4, 7, and the second cluster contains 7.4, 6.2, 6.4, 7.3, 8.5, and 7.6. Now, partitioning around medoids says that for a given set of medoids, at any iteration it selects that exchange which has some minimum SAA, that is sum of absolute error. The procedure terminates if there is no change in the SAE in successive iteration, that is there is no change in the medoid. This K-medoid algorithm is also known as PAM, that is partitioning around medoids. Illustration of PAM. Suppose there are a set of 12 objects whose set contains from O1 to O12. And we are to cluster them into 4 clusters. At any instant, the 4 clusters C1, C2, C3 and C4 are shown in figure 16.7a. Also assume that O1, O2, O3 and O4 are the medoids in the clusters. There are many ways to choose a non-medoid object to be replaced any one medoid object. Out of these, suppose if O5 is considered as candidate medoid instead of O4, then it gives the lowest SAE, that is sum of absolute error. Thus, the new set of medoids would be O1, O2, O3 and O5. The new cluster is shown in figure 16.7b. Now partitioning around medoids, here the clusters have been displayed with the medoids value, that is C1 has 3 points and 1 medoid, that is open. C2 has 2. O12 and O2, in which the red point is the cluster or cluster's medoid value, chosen medoid value. Here in C3, O5, O11, O3 and O10 are the 4 clusters item and whose O3 is medoid. Here O4, O8 and O7 are the 3 members of these clusters with medoid is O4. After swapping O4 and O5, O4 and O5 objects swapping becomes the new medium, then O5 becomes the new one. Look, C4 cluster, C3 C2 had to O12 and O2. Here they are O7, O6, O1, then O3 in the next side. Look after swapping. Now PAM algorithm does a procedure of iterative selection of medoids, and it is precisely stated in algorithm 16 point, that is PAM. It takes the input database of objects D and K the number of desired clusters. Output would be set of K clusters, and the steps have been explained here. That first step is that arbitrary select K medoids from D, and the second step is for each object OI, not a medoid, do. Third step, for each medoid OJ, do. Fourth step says that let M is the set of object from A1 to OK, set of current medoids, and M complement is a set of O1 to OK set of medoids, but swap with non-medoid. Fifth step says that cost calculate cost OI OJ, that will be nothing but SA, calculating of SA, M minus SA M complement. Six is the end of two for loop. Now the seventh step says that find OI OJ for which the cost OI AJ is smallest, that is we have to choose the smallest of the all the distances, and replace. Eighth step says that replace OI with OJ and accordingly update the set M. Ninth step says that repeat steps 2 to step 8 until cost is less than 0. And the 10th step says that return the cluster with M as a set of cluster centers. Last step is stop. Comparing K means with K medoids. Both algorithms needs to fix K, the number of clusters, prior to the algorithms. Also, the OAuth algorithm arbitrarily choose the initial cluster centroid. The K medoid method is more robust than K means in the presence of outliers, because a medoid is less influenced by outliers than a mean. Then time complexity of M. For each iteration, PAM consider K multiplied by N minus K pairs of object OI OJ for which a cost host OI comma OJ determines. Calculating the cost during each iteration requires that the cost be calculated for all other non-medoid OJs. There are n minus k of these. Thus, the total time complexity per iteration is n multiplied by n minus k or to the power 2. The number, the total number of iterations may be quite large. Third is the application of PAM. PAM does not scheme well to large database because of its computation complexity. Now other variants of K-medoid algorithms are, there are some variants of this partition around medoids algorithms, that are targeted mainly for large data sets are, one of them is Clara, that is clustering large application, and Clarence, that is clustering large applications based upon randomized search. It is an improvement of Clara. Now for these extended versions of Clara and Clarence, we have taken the references from the following are the references that we have taken. Now for PAM and Clara, we have taken the reference from and finding groups in data and introduction to cluster analysis, written by John and Wille 1919. And the authors are L. Kaufman and P.J. Rosevi. For Clarence, we have taken the reference R. Nagarjuna and H. NG and H. and J. Hen. Efficient and effective clustering methods for subspatial data mining. Proceedings, very large database, that is VLDB 1994. Thank you very much for today's lecture. Patience. Have a nice day. Thank you.